What we're doing today is actually going out and looking at a spill response operation and what we would do in case there was an oil spill and testing our response capability. And so this is really a practice session to make sure that we do the right things should a spill occur.
We're going to be deploying a CTD system with a particle sizer on board. And we're also going to be deploying a gravity core as well.
Well, one of the things that we do in sciences, and especially in oil spills, is trying to understand what happens to oil when it's spilled in the environment naturally, and what happens if we're using various technologies to clean up oil spills, because none of them are effective 100%. At the same time, we have to have a basic understanding in the marine environment on what's going out there now before we have any pollution events. So in a case of a pollution event, when we do oil spill cleanup and look at recovery, when do we know the environment has recovered? So it's a large spectrum of work that we do. It covers all aspects of oceanography.
The kind of expertise we've got on board is a whole load of geochemists. We've got a GIS specialist, geographical information specialist. We've also got geologists and marine geologists on board. So it's a whole set of skills that we bring together to be able to do this kind of work. It's not just marine scientists. And that's one of the great things that we have at CSIRO, is this ability to build multidisciplinary teams and then deploy them in events such as oil spills.
Today we deployed our gravity cora, which is a cora which employs a 100 kilo weight on the top, and you hang the cora over the back of the vessel, and the weights on the top literally make the cora travel at speed through the water column, and then the mass just pushes that cora straight into the sediment. We also deployed our CTD, which as you go down through the water it will just literally log your conductivity, temperature and depth. And attached to that we also used our list, and that is measuring particle size. So for our purposes, what we would want to use that for would be when you have oil seepage, or maybe in an instant response, we're looking for oil droplets through the water column, and then you can see if you've got underwater plumes of oil and that kind of thing.
One of the big projects we have now is in the Great Australian Bight, where we're trying to understand what the environment is like out there prior to any oil spill events. So therefore, should a spill occur, we know what to monitor, we know where the valued ecosystem components are, where we should focus for oil spill response to protect the environment. Well, the ocean means a lot to me because I grew up around the ocean. And of course, if you look at it, our future for the world is really looking at the ocean, because that's where our resources will be in the future.